Well, it's known for its tasty pies, but today Hubig's has a beef with those cashing in on its name or brand. WDSU anchor LaTanya Norton is on your side with that story and what's next for the company.
It was just last month that Hubig Pie's factory burned to the ground in a five-alarm fire. Today, unsolicited campaigns are causing a firestorm of controversy. When an early morning fire on July 27th destroyed the Hubig's Pie factory in the Marigny, many watched in disbelief as the iconic institution went up in flames. The raging fire sparked a tremendous outpouring of community support.
I think it's great that so many people want to help, but you just have to go about it the right way.
Lauren Tom, a Florida girl, is among a handful of local entrepreneurs helping Hubig's raise money to rebuild. She's sold 918 t-shirts so far, raising more than $9,000 after signing a contract with Hubig's owner.
I think that that's important, is that just to make sure that you know, you have an agreement in place. And I know that we do. I can't speak for the other businesses.
We did not get permission to them, but we aren't using their logo. We're just using their name.
Which is unauthorized. The company's website clearly asks that anyone using Hubig's name, brand, or likeness to cease, citing many unsolicited campaigns. Our brand is of the utmost importance to the future of the company, and until we are making pies again, it is our most important asset.
We did it for 10 days, and we donated all our profits to them. And we cut them a nice check last week for that.
The idea behind the t-shirts, behind the glass ornaments, behind any of that, with maybe the exception of the eBay sales, which are clearly profiteering, the heart was in the right place to do something to support an icon.
And the little fried pies are practically impossible to find. Lovers of Hubig's hope the company will rebuild right here in its same location. On your side in the Marigny, LaTanya Norton, WDSU News.
Hubig's owner, Andrew Ramsey, says there is a handful of organizations licensed to use its trademark. Meantime, plans are in the works to open a temporary shop in Orleans or Jefferson Parish. When asked if the company will rebuild in the Marigny, Ramsey said, quote, "That's a code and financial issue," end quote.